In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily copy all file names in Windows folders to Microsoft Excel using MS-DOS. You might not know this, but with your Windows installation, you get a choice of four operating systems. Here's a quick overview of these operating systems. You get the Microsoft Windows operating system, which comes with a graphic user interface, also known as a GUI. Then, you also have the Microsoft Disk operating system, MS-DOS. This is the operating system that Windows replaced. It's a non-graphical operating system, and you access it using the command prompt, also known as CMD. You also have .NET. This is a cross-platform operating system that comes with Windows. It's modern, more powerful than MS-DOS. On Windows, you access it via the PowerShell. Finally, you have Linux, only recent versions of Windows 10, so you can easily learn Ubuntu on your Windows machine. Let me also give a shout out to Visual Basic for Applications, or VBA, because it's a great way to extend the functionality of Microsoft Office, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and so forth, and I use it a lot, so you should also check it out. Anyways, in this video, I'm going to show you how to copy file names into Excel using MS-DOS operating system. In a previous video, I showed you how to copy file names in a folder to Excel using Windows. If you want me to show you how to perform the same task using PowerShell and Linux, let me know in the comment section below. Now, before we jump into MS-DOS, you'll need to know two MS-DOS commands, CD and DIR. CD is short for Change Directory. This is a command you use to navigate through directories, also known as folders, in a drive. DIR is short for directory and is used to display information about contents of the current directory. In Windows terms, the contents of the current folder. With that out of the way, let me show you how to copy file names into Excel using MS-DOS. Click on Windows Search or Cortana and search for Command Prompt or CMD. Command Prompt will show up in the search results. Click on it to launch or press Enter. Alternatively, you can also launch CMD from the Run command. Simultaneously press the Windows and R keys and then type CMD. Click OK or press Enter to launch Command Prompt. Now, open Windows Explorer and navigate to the folder that contains the files and folders. Click on the address bar to reveal the folder path. Note the drive letter, in this case it's G, and then copy the folder path. Head back to Command Prompt and type the drive letter and a colon. The drive that contains the folder that contains my files is drive G, so I type G colon, then hit Enter. This is how you navigate to drives in MS-DOS. Type in the drive letter, colon, and hit Enter. Now that we're in the right drive, let's navigate to the folder that contains the files. We'll use the change directory command. So type CD space, then right click with your mouse. Right clicking with your mouse pastes the folder path that we copied from the address bar. Press Enter, and you have successfully navigated to the folder that contains your files. Now, we are going to use the DIR command, which displays the contents of the folder, to display the contents of the folder in Excel. So we type the DIR command, and then we tell it where to post the output. That's achieved by typing a space, greater than sign, then the name of the output file. MS-DOS will automatically create this file in the current folder. I want to name my output file as list, and I want DOS to create an Excel file, so I'll use the .xls as the file extension, and then press Enter. If we go back to the current folder in Windows Explorer, you can see that the list.xls file has been created, and opening it, we can see the name of our files, or not. Okay, so a few things to note here. We only have one file name, and that's the list.xls. So if we save the Excel file in the current folder MSDOS will also output the list name in our file. So let's change that. I want to save the output Excel file in this folder. So I'll click on the address bar and copy the folder path. You can save the output file in any folder you want. Let's head back to CMD and specify where MSDOS should save the file. I'll type dir again, space greater than sign, then I'll right click to paste the folder path of the folder where I want to save the Excel file. Type a forward slash, then the name of the file, list.xls, then hit enter. Now, if we go back to the folder in Explorer, we can see that the list.xls has been created. Let's open it and you can see that it only has the folder name. The next thing we need to do is get MSDOS to output the file names in the subfolders. So going back to command prompt, let's see the attributes or filters that we can add to the dir command. To access the help menu in MSDOS, you type help and the command. So I'll type help dir. All right, here are all the options of the dir command. We are looking for subfolders. Here we go, forward slash s displays files in a specified directory and all subdirectories. Let's add that to our dir command. I'm going to use the up arrow to scroll through my previous commands. Here is the dir command with the specified folder path. Use the back arrow to move the cursor to just before r, and then type forward slash and s. Press the end key to take the cursor back to the end of the line, and press the enter key to execute. Back to the Explorer and open the list file. Okay, so now we have the folder names and all the file names in the subfolders. We also have the date modified and all this other information. Let's remove all that information and also sort the file names alphabetically. We've already run the dir help command, and here's the output. So looking at it, we can see that stroke A displays files with specific attributes, but we can also use it to not display files with specific attributes using the minus prefix. We don't want directories or folders, so A minus D should filter out the folder names. And we can see from the help command how to write it out. A colon attribute. So let us add that to our dir command. A colon minus D attribute. Let's scroll up and look at other filters that we can use. So forward slash B uses the bare format. No heading information or summary. Let's add that. Forward slash B. Finally, we want to sort the file names alphabetically. We can use slash O to list files in sorted order. And sort order N is by names. How do we write that? O colon sort order. Okay, so let's add that. Forward slash O colon N. Let's run this command by pressing enter and look at the output. That looks good. What if I just wanted the names of the audio file, so only the WAV files? Let's add a search wildcard to the dir command. So *.wav. This will look for all the files with a .wav extension. I'm also going to change the output file name to list1. Press enter and let's look at the Excel file. And here we have all the names of the WAV files. Finally, let me show you a quick way to remove all the folder paths if you don't want them. Press Ctrl A to select all the file names. In the Excel main menu, click on Data, then Text Columns. Click on Next, check Other, and we are going to use the forward slash as our delimiter. Click Next. I don't want to overwrite my current data, so I'll set the destination as another cell out of my data range. Then click Finish. Now, you'll have all the file names in one column, and you can delete the rest of the columns and have just the file names in your Excel sheet. Save the file and you're done. That's it for this video. Hope you learned something new. See you next time.